someone is reviewing us and praising and somewhere in, you know, Malaysia, I mean everywhere.
True.
So we are very much overwhelmed.
The sensibilities of filmmaking, they talk about screenplay, they talk about background scoring and all those things, even a small...
This is what everybody grew up listening to stories, right? Right from the childhood, and we, most of us will have that desire to tell story. Like
initially we started in 2019 once we pitched the script to Rajan DK and Goa Film Bazaar.
Then Veerababu paying the villagers, the villagers ask us if we come and act, how are we gonna get our wages for the day.
V4U மீடியா நேயர்களுக்கு வணக்கம். இன்னைக்கு நம்ம கூட யார் இருக்காங்கன்னு பார்த்தீங்கன்னா ஒரு ரொம்ப ஸ்பெஷலான டீம்னு சொல்லணும். ஏன்னா சமீபத்தில் அவங்க நடிச்சிருக்கிற அண்ட் ப்ரொடியூஸ் பண்ணியிருக்கிற படங்கள் வந்து அந்த மாதிரி இருந்திருக்கு. வி ஹாவ் வித் அஸ் டுடே தி அமேசிங் டீம் ஆஃப் சினிமா பந்தி. வணக்கம். ஹலோ.
வணக்கம்.
ஹலோ ஹலோ ஹலோ
வணக்கம்.
ஹவ் ஆர் யூ?
எல்லாருக்கும் வணக்கம்.
ரொம்ப நல்லா இருக்கு.
Congratulations on the huge success of the film Cinema Bandi.
Thank you so much. Romba nandri ellarkum.
Romba nandri.
மக்களே, ஐ லைக் டு இன்ஃபார்ம் யூ ப்ரையர், பிகாஸ் இவங்க வந்து தெலுங்கு சினிமா பேஸ் பண்ணதுனால தமிழ் வந்து லைட் தெரியாது. பட் வி வில் எனிவே மேனேஜ் டு கீப் யூ இன்டராக்டிவ் த்ரூ அவுட் திஸ் இன்டர்வியூ செஷன். ஸோ கைண்ட்லி பார்டன் அஸ் வித் இங்கிலீஷ் தட் வீல் பி ப்ரொசீடிங் வித். ஸோ வீல் ஸ்டார்ட் வித் த டைரக்டர், பிகாஸ் திஸ் இஸ் யுவர் டெபியூ ஃபிலிம் இன் தெலுங்கு சினிமா. ஸோ ஹவ் வாஸ் த ரெஸ்பான்ஸ் கமிங் யுவர் வே?
யா, இட்ஸ் ட்ரெமெண்டஸ் ஃபார் எ ஸ்மால் ஃபிலிம் லைக் திஸ். இட்ஸ் எ ட்ரெமெண்டஸ் ரெஸ்பான்ஸ். We didn't expect this kind of response from everybody, but we trusted, like, we made a good film. That is always there in us. We made a good film, so it's good that people are loving it across India, because we love cinema so much. So Cinema Bandi is connecting to everybody, every heart. I think it's connecting to every heart, and they're posting, they're reposting, they're thinking it's their movie. It's their movie. It's dedicated to all filmmakers who love cinema. So I think it's an amazing response with all over India.
And for the rest, how was the response coming your way about your performance, about your contribution towards the film?
Like my t-shirt reads. So it's that. Sorry. So, yeah, I mean, it's been amazing. We know that we have made a good film, a very good film. And we knew that we would bring smiles, but not at this scale. Not from, you know, somewhere in Bengal, someone is reviewing us and praising it. Somewhere in, you know, Malaysia, I mean, everywhere.
True.
So, we are very much overwhelmed. So, yeah.
Yeah. And about the writers are one of the biggest pillars of support technically paakumbodhu. So how was it being a part of such a great film like Cinema Bandi?
I think this is the this is the luckiest thing that happened in my life. That's what I can say, because meeting Praveen and working on this film, right, that actually changed my life. That's what I can say, because the movie and the kind of platform that's it's getting played, right, then entire India is actually talking about, yeah, Cinema Bandi. I'm getting calls from my Tamil friends, I'm getting calls from my Hindi friends, Malayalam friends and all, and the dialogues are getting getting repeated by many people, like Nee Pere Me, or the small poem which says Endalo Nedalo Nedalo Avla, all those things, right? People are actually remembering, and they're trying to say it in different styles. So I think that's actually a big success for everybody, because we actually touched a lot of people's emotions in these hard times. So we thought, I say that all our hard work, the hard work that we have gone through, right, that actually is worth, actually, when after seeing this result. That too is just 4 days, and we are like super, I mean, exponentially we got the feedback from people, like the word of mouth spread like exponentially. So we are very thankful for Rajandike for that's the reason why we got such a big platform, and it went into a lot of easily into different people, right? So yeah, that's my response.
Yeah, it's been a tremendous response. We always knew that we are making a great film. In fact, all these lines when we were discussing, right, when we were coming up with these scenes and lines, we have enjoyed thoroughly. Like, we ourselves had fun, like a laugh, right, all the time. But, you know, while making the movie, we were only thinking how it is, and we were so excited about those lines and all. But when they came out, right, though we knew that they would be good, when we actually are experiencing it, it feels surreal. It's like, yeah, we can't believe it, you know, because thinking is one thing and feeling is another thing, right? But also, yeah, like Vasant and all said, it's because of Raj and DK that we are on Netflix today and everybody is able to watch the film. And the thing is, even the people who doesn't know the language are able to connect to it so well.
Exactly.
So, yeah. So we were thinking, yeah, dialogues are one of the main strengths which are being repeated everywhere in the social media. Memes, oh my God, a hell lot of memes that all our phones are like flooded with memes. Totally. If you want to search for a pic, we are not getting it. It's like somewhere lost in the memes. So yeah, it's been really good.
So the tagline of the film, everyone is a filmmaker at heart, which is eventually the message of the film as well. How do you connect or associate this with your personal life? Anyone can answer. Anyone can go ahead.
So, Maritesh, you can start.
Oh, Praveen, you are the best to answer this actually.
Yeah. So see, basically we love cinema from, like, I think India loves cinema from when we are born. We used to live life with cinema. Everywhere we used to get influence. Cinema is something which is very personal to us. When I'm a kid, I went to this theater watching this big screen. Like, we used to watch all kind of cinema, right? Cinema will trigger us so much. So when I was like 7 plus only, I started small movie stuff. So when my father got a camera, so we used to make this Jugad filmmaking and all stuff. At the time, there is no YouTube. Yeah. At the time, there is no YouTube, there is nothing, basically. It's just this camera, and we want to do something and we want to put it out. So cinema is something which is very personal to me, and I want to, my debut should be something about cinema. It's always there. So that is everybody's a filmmaker at heart, connects everybody. So that is something which I always feel. So that is the reason we are talking in Tamil show. A Telugu cinema is topped by Tamil show, that itself says that we reached India.
Okay. So yeah, please welcome our Veera Babu along with us today. Vikas Vasish.
Hi.
Thank you for joining.
Hello, Vikas.
Hey,
so only he knows Tamil. Tamil he knows very well.
That's how we met.
Yeah, we met him as a Tamil actor.
Okay, that's interesting.
So, Solinga Faraz, how are you doing?
I'm doing great. It's just been some 5 minutes when we started. We were discussing
it was another call.
No issues. So we were discussing about how everyone is a filmmaker at heart, and how do you associate that with your personal life?
Talk in Tamil, because talk in Tamil.
So yeah, at least you could give me company and keep our audience engaged throughout.
Right. Absolutely. Because I come from a place called KJF, so I know Tamil. That's all. Yeah, basically, everyone is a filmmaker at heart. We all come from the same thing. I mean, ellarkum irukum. There is one saturation level where we okay, nanu edavadhu pannanum. Something really creative and which is engaging. Abdi edavadhu pannanumna everyone will have a first option as filmmaking.
Yeah.
Blindly. Blinda or decision on the road, nano or movie panano. either it is a short film or a feature film or anything, or someone want to nan acting pananom illa na direct pananom illa edavadhu something related to the industry itself, editing, like that. So this is how this movie is more of that na team la ellaro apdi dhaan irukanga. Not that ki okay I am doing here just for money or just for fame or something like that. Ellarku and the film mela or love irukla,
yeah,
that is immense, and that is how the results are showing up now.
Nice. So who would like to go ahead?
Adding to that, so whenever we say somebody, right, that I'm a filmmaker or I'm into filmmaking, the first thing we see in their face is excitement, and they come up to me, oh, even I like filmmaking, oh, you're into filmmaking, even I tried a short film once, or even I wanted to do, but you know, I couldn't because I have to work, because you know, there's some financial liability associated, right, to everybody. So everybody can't pursue it, but everybody has it in them. Either they want to act or direct and all. So that's like there with everybody. Though a lot of people, that's the response we get from a lot of people. So that's like a very true statement. Also, everybody discusses every film, and everybody has their own opinion, right? They're like, if the scene was a little better, this would have been good. Even now we get that kind of response, okay? This could have been good. I mean, from ordinary people, not necessarily from the people in the industry, right? So there is a filmmaker in everybody. Also, rightly said in one of the review, I don't remember the website, Veera Babu didn't become a filmmaker by finding the camera. He became a filmmaker while he faced all the issues and difficulties while casting, all of that process. That process is what made him a filmmaker. Like going through that process is what made him a filmmaker, not just finding a camera. So that's the only difference. Everybody, they have it in them. Doing or not doing it is the only difference.
Adding to that, today the audience is like very so smart and so sensible that they understand the sensibilities of filmmaking. They talk about screenplay, they talk about background scoring and all those things. Even a small dialogue, if it is adu konjo adhigama irundhalum they say idu thevailla,
yeah,
thevailla. So they are that smart enough and that sensible enough, so that is one thing which will connect them to okay nangala try pannalam. Not try parano. I don't want to do this. I don't want to do that. I want to do this. Na irunda adu pannirukka mata. All these thought processes comes and then they start, okay, let's do something.
Okay.
So mine will be quick actually, because KP Vikas already covered almost everything. So this is what everybody grew up listening to stories, right? Right from the childhood, and we, most of us, will have that desire to tell story. Like I want to tell a story, so and make people engaged in that. So I had this 6630 Nokia mobile, very small screen, in which I wanted to make a small film. So that was the beginning, and whenever I read this caption, right, everybody is a filmmaker at heart. So I go to those days, like that's, I didn't have any equipment or anything, but that small act of making or telling a story in that small mobile phone actually bought a lot of energy or happiness in my positive energy, and showing it to my friends. So that's where I began, and that never never ended. The desire to tell a story never ended. It actually grew exponentially again. So this actually will be present in maybe many people, like because of the survival issues or because of the various routines, right? Survival routines, people actually won't be much involved or getting into this field. But I feel that the the desire to tell a story will be present in everybody. That's what this caption actually means. So yeah, that's the only point I wanted to add, because they covered everything. Yeah.
Okay.
Sorry, boss.
So you made my work easy.
Yeah. So how long did this entire process take, right from the pre-production to filming the entire writing on screen? Did it go according to what you had planned, or it took quite a couple of days later?
Yeah, see, initially we started in 2019 months. Then we pitched the script to Raj and DK in Goa Film Bazaar.
Hmm.
Started from there, we just had an idea. We just had an idea of an auto guy will find a camera and he will do a movie. That's the idea we have. So after that, me and Vasant wrote the whole script. We made a short film. So that short film turned out to be a feature film after Raj and DK liked the short film. And it's a long process. Like on the script stage, me, Vasant, KP, we worked on a lot. We wanted, there are many versions. We used to have this small board in our in my room, and we used to have this whole flowchart. So every day we used to sit and work on the script. It's like, it's a very big process. We used to go to sometimes we used to go to Mumbai, me and Vasant and the team, and we used to discuss the script with Raj and DK. And there are many discussions. There are some conflicts between us. We have to resolve that. So every scene should have a specific time. So we used to plan everything. Like it should not go 3 hours long. So every scene would pinpoint. So that is what we worked on a lot on the script. The highs and the lows. So there is a lot of research had been done. Definitely Vasant created all these characters. All these Maridesh, Manga. So he created this world of Cinema Bandi, these
because
names
I
and all.
I'm curious to know about the names, like
yeah.
Babu, Ganapati and the others. I just wanted to know interesting names as well as characters. So you gave us the answer.
Yeah, Vasant, you can talk about the name, how do you got these characters and all.
Yeah, every character.
And also Swarna Manjari, how did you come up with that name? Was it a random throw of names or...
It was, I don't know actually from where I got that name, seriously.
It was in that book, the storybook which Tata had.
Right.
And there is another twist in the end, in the climax. I even wanted to discuss about the
spoiler
name.
Spoiler alert.
Yes, spoiler.
Okay, let's not go to that part. But yeah, tell us about the names and how did you come up with the characterization and stuff.
Names right now, every name is a major, like they were either my friends or I had some relation with them throughout my life. So either during my college days or engineering days or somebody. So every character, Veerababu, Ganapati, Maridaya, everybody were somewhat close to me, and I actually had some relation with them. So I found it easy to name the characters. I mean, even though they are exactly not the same as the movie Veerababu or movie Maridaya, but the thing is, I found it somewhat, I'm able to relate to something, pick up from a scratch, like instead of having a normal Kartik or something, right, which will be which I can't relate to, but I thought these picking up from somebody from my life actually gave it more life to the character. So that's what, I don't know if it makes sense, but that's what I did it. So Swaramanjari is one thing, I don't know, from some novel or something I got that name. I seriously don't know about that. Yeah, but rest all character names, as I said.
So Cinema Bandi had its share of emotional moments as well as hilarious ones. And one particular scene, I almost laughed my heart out in most of the scenes, but one particular scene that had the entire family, you know, rolling down and laughing, ROFL is exactly what means. That is the train chasing sequence where everyone is running behind and the hero just jumps into the train, leaving the heroine behind. And that entire scene was made up really well. So who came up with that idea, that scene and everything? Tell us about that making.
There is a small thing here which is deleted. So after the train scene, they all go to the police station. So we deleted that scene. So because of the train sequence, they're doing all the jugaad.
Okay.
So this police will catch them and there'll be huge, it's a very big scene in the police station.
Oh my god.
That is all deleted. Maybe
second part. Let us not reveal any of those.
I'm so glad there is a second part in the making. So
you guys remember there was a dialogue to the SI saying that, oh, chichpera, sir.
No.
So yeah, definitely that was a very funny scene where we have to shoot. Actually, that the train comes only two times, the morning 6 o'clock and 10 o'clock. So
okay.
We have to get the shot in two times. We don't have any other option. So we went at 5 o'clock. We are waiting for the train. They don't know what's happening also. It's some really thinking that what's happening. Like there some gundas are chasing. Some guys are really thinking something is real happening.
Seriously,
because they didn't put the camera there.
Huh.
Yeah. So it was very funny. The train is coming. The station is just like 500 meters away. So we are just here. So we know when the train comes. So we have to get the shot when the train is going. So we had 5 cameras set up to not miss any shot. So it's a magic. We don't know how we are gonna get it because Maridesh should not get into the train. If you I don't know how it actually worked. You did not see Maridesh actually getting into the train.
Yeah.
It's a magic. The train goes, the shot cut to Manga falling down. So that is a technique we followed with the budget constraints we have. So it looks like he actually get into the train.
So since the train comes just twice, did you practice that prior and just fix it? Okay, we have to go get this right.
No
practice at all. Spot.
We just had the.
How would you imagine a train and a track? And where would you imagine a train and a track?
There was just a gut feel that we have 5 cameras. One or the other camera will capture what we really wanted. That's it.
No, but that was one amazing scene. And then there is another market scene where it kind of, you know, it starts to rain and then you dance and it's, this is my manga, just get off her. And then that entire thing gets captured in the end, towards the end. So that was one among the funniest scenes. So tell us about some funny incident that didn't get captured on screen, but actually happened on set while you were filming the entire thing.
The most funny thing is even we lost current. The whole movie also, the current, because shoot is happening, like shoot stops it, there is no power. Even for us also, shooting used to stop without power, like when there's no power. So mostly every incident which is happening in the movie, it's actually happening for us. For example, if there is a scene where Veer Babu, they're calling Maridesh Babu and Divya, they're not coming to the set, right? The same situation happened just before half an hour. The camera department did not come. The sync department did not come. I'm just calling everybody. Please come to the set.
We have to
shoot that scene actually. So it was a magic. The two scenes happening at the same time.
So how long did
I was just adding to that. So since we had the power, you could ask if we couldn't use the, why can't we use the generators and all. But we were having sync sound recorded. So there's no option for us to use generator as well, because that sound will get picked up, right? So also you see them, Veer Babu paying the villagers. The villagers ask us if we come and act, how are we going to get our wages for the day? So that we did that. I mean, when we asked for people to, you know, we used a lot of villagers in our movie. They were playing the extras and so they asked us, ki, if we come and play here, how are we going to get our daily wages? They did. So that was also inspired. A lot of things happen actually.
So this and seems to be like a semi-biopic on Team Cinema Bandi. By the experiences you're sharing, this is what I can conclude with.
Yeah, this is
and one more thing. Yeah, one more thing actually. One of the most active guy on the set was the Tata. Okay. Suddenly he disappears. Okay. Suddenly he disappears and everybody will be like, where is Tata? Where is Tata? He will be somewhere inside the fields doing something inside the field with his goats or something. And the AD guys and all will run, Tata, what are you doing there? You should come here. You should be in the set. And they will bring him here. He will be like, Yandappa, Yanda shooting, Rosanta shooting, Antaru Meru. So having that guy on the set all the time, right? I mean, it's understandable. He's like 65 or something. But one person needs to have an eye on that guy, not to lose him. Like he shouldn't go somewhere or anything. But that was one funny incident. Like trying to.
You can rather put it this way that he kept everyone active.
Right. right.
And one more interesting fact is that he did not utter even a single word, but still he managed to steal the entire attention.
He actually every time he used to ask, give me one dialogue, I know how to act, please give me one dialogue. He like, why are you not giving at least one dialogue? So he's like so much. So I always, there is one dialogue at the end which everybody is going to laugh. That was the thing I gave to him. So that was a very funny.
So who came up with the closing, that twist in the tail, kind of a closing? Whose idea was it? In the writing, or it was all of a sudden plan, or you already had it written before?
It was not starting sudden plan on the making on the edit, we actually thought there are three four dialogues which he actually told at the end. Like we kept, this is the best thing, we found it's very funny. There are other three versions of Tata telling the same situation again. Like he will be asking BD, like some other dialogue, right? Vasant might know.
Yeah, there is one more thing actually. Tata, will you come to city? You will learn a lot being a writer. So that's one thing. And some other thing. And he will say, okay, can I get some money for my BD or something? So that's the other thing. But yeah, we thought after discussing, right, this is the best one.
So tell us about being associated with the master makers Raj and DK. Because that is a brand by itself.
See, it is like, I will tell you, it is like a normal phone having an Apple logo on it. So it is like our movie is launching by Netflix and Raj and DK. While watching only, they will feel there is something in the movie. Like they will not think movie is good or bad. They will watch it with an expectation that yes, this movie is going to tell something. So that is a brand which you're having, right? Because of that brand, it went so viral, which I always do. Yeah.
So like you had mentioned, sorry?
It also really helped us in the making of the film. Okay, you know, since we were this is our first time, all of us are like first timers, when we were trying to pull in people, how could they trust us, right? So one thing was that we were showing the short film, and the other thing, since we are low in budget and all, when they were asking for stuff, we were like, we have Raj and DK, okay, we have Raj and DK with us. Raj and DK believes us, which means there's something.
So that actually added advantage.
Mentoring.
Yeah, that was really.
Yeah, their mentoring also, I think, really helped a lot to, refine the film and, you know, polish the film in the right way. So I think there is a lot of almost double the footage of what you're seeing now. So it's their vision to put exactly what is needed, I think. Are they connected with the right people to this? So now you don't feel any lag in the film. I think because there's not even 1 second extra or 1 second less for any character or for any situation in the film. So I think their vision and their experience and their own sense of humor and their quirkiness helped the film. If you even look at their previous films also, you won't see them too long. They'll be mostly under 2 hours.
be it Stree, Gogo Agon, anything for that matter, whatever they made. So they know what works. So that mentoring to Vasant and Praveen, I think, helped a lot. So yeah, I mean, at every level we had a good technician, include from Raj and DK to the ADs. So yeah,
you know, every actor watched the movie with you all guys. Netflix is a launch for all the actors. Only me, Vasant, know the movie. Nobody knows the movie. How is going to be? So it's a preview for everybody.
So how was the
I did too just the last edit
and to add to those points, right, just one thing, Raj and DK's experience, right, it helped a lot during the writing process, because a particular scene or sequence, right, when we placed at a particular time period of the script, they were able to forecast that it won't work at that particular point. Okay, they are ready to debate very organically. They never said they gave us the reason why something won't work, and they helped us learn why the length shouldn't be more or length should be short, right? So they had this experience which helped us a lot in understanding this entire script flow and what works or what doesn't work. Hopefully some part we got it from them. Maybe if we work again, some more experience we can grab from them.
I think that should happen.
Yeah, we didn't go to film school actually, so that experience itself was like a film school for us.
Yeah,
since they're not just producers, they themselves are writer directors, so working, and they do work so well, like they it's same like me, Vasant, and Praveen working. When we are working with them, we feel the same way. They coordinate so equally. We wouldn't hesitate to share an idea with them because they are so open to it, and they'll give us reasons, like Vasant said, why it will work or why it wouldn't. So that itself was like a film school for us.
So generally, any producer, when you look at any producer, they say add some songs here. Add some points here.
Some producers.
Like
basically, basically a commercial producers.
Yeah. Mm. It's quite opposite with Raj and DK. When me and Vasant try to serve, we can add this much. No. Let it be this. Let's not cross the border. So
basically, right. They doesn't want to commercialize it.
So that helped us a lot in understanding cinema. We like, see, everybody is on the same page. The producer, director, the writer, actors. When everybody is on the same page, we get an output like Cinema Bandi. So that is what happened. Cinema
Bandi. Very well put.
Yeah. So you've been part of this amazing film, but introspecting it on a very general point of view, which was your favorite scene from the film? Of course, the entire film would be a thing very close to your heart. But while you sit back and watch, oh my God, this scene has some magic yaar in it, like something that you come up with. Your favorite pick, your favorite scene from the film, which one would you choose?
I'll go first.
So that nobody can say that scene again, right?
No, I don't think anyone will say it. So there's a scene where after everything is gone and gone with the wind, Maridesh, I'm telling my own scene, sorry, self-obsessed. So yeah, so he's in the barber shop, and from that apparent stardom for himself, he's back to the barber shop, and the customer makes a quick smile at him and says, what happened to your hero, this thing and all. And he just calmly goes, gazes, and he takes that knife and goes to his armpit. And, back to this life. So that moment, when I watched, I don't know whether I felt so much while doing that scene, but when I watched it on screen, I literally got tears. So that was my favorite scene.
That was actually one hard-hitting reality, because most of us who dream of making something big into cinema, we often face things like that in life. So, yeah.
Yeah, and my favorite scene was the charger scene when the kid
the poultry thing.
The charger, no, not the poultry, the small
the,
girl.
The daughter plugs in from the school.
It's a beautiful scene. Whenever I watch it, it gets that smile on your face.
My mom was like cheering up when the daughter was running to give the charger to her dad. My mom was like cheering up. She was that happy and glad seeing that.
That scene is kind of inspiration from the Color of Paradise.
Okay.
When they exchange the shoes, when the small kid exchange the shoes, right? That was something very beauty on it.
Children of Heaven.
Children of Heaven, yeah.
Yeah, yeah.